Elsie. Welcome to the Roundtable Podcast. We've created this space for Ni Vanuatu women to speak freely on issues affecting us today. Let's navigate life in the islands together. Join me as I speak to a new guest every episode and ask the questions you've always wanted to ask. Ale, Umi Storian. This project is made possible with the support of the We Rise Coalition and PACMAS. We will be exploring dress codes according to Vanuatu societal standards. And I have with me today the lovely Miss Umi. Hi, Umi.
Hi.
Thank you for joining me on this episode. Before we, you know, delve into this conversation, maybe you can tell us a little bit about yourself.
Sure. So I'm not originally from Vanuatu, but I did grow up here. I used to work here at siSTAR. I left somewhere September last year to pursue other careers, and now I'm working in real estate. I work for iProperty Vanuatu. I was quite surprised to hear you guys, to see that you guys have reached out to me to come be a part of this, because I was a part of this when it started, and then, you know, I left, but I'm very happy to be back and to discuss this with you.
Thank you, Umi. So that is a fun fact. And, you know, it's a great circle of events for you to be here on the podcast as a guest now. So thank you so much again for coming. So I've already, you know, introduced the topic. We're going to be talking about dress codes. Now, before we get into the, you know, nitty gritty and all these different questions, I just wanted to get your perspective on the topic. You know, what comes to mind when you hear the word dress code, and like relating it back to our context here in Vanuatu?
When I hear dress code, I immediately think, you know, what's acceptable to wear. That's literally what comes to mind. Or, you know, what's okay to wear, what's not okay to wear. Because whenever people say dress code, it's always something, it's strict, you know?
Exactly. And I think for those of you who aren't from Vanuatu, you know, there are different dress codes for different places. You know, we have dress codes for certain events if you work at a, you know, particular office, or we have dress codes for communities, Umi Wayumi Stapla Island. And so there are all these different dress codes that we could address in this conversation, but I want us to start off with just a personal observation that I've realized, you know, that when a woman who is confidently curvy or is, you know, on the slimmer side, you know, wears something, it can be any outfit at all, people are always quick to judge. People will always have something to say about what they're wearing. And, you know, it even goes to the extent of them body shaming the woman and her outfit. You know, I've been in situations where people will say, oh, you know, if she was a little slimmer, she would look good in that outfit. Or there's a phrase that I'm not sure if we still use this, but it's a phrase that people will use here to describe someone who's very skinny. And so, you know, it's like the common phrase that I will hear and that kind of annoys me is, you know, body blame is stick broom to mass. Make us a dresser in a really nice lahem. And, you know, I'm sure you've heard people say those kind of things as well, and it's annoyingly common. And so, you know, have you ever experienced body shaming, or have you heard it happen to someone else?
I think every girl, whether you're thin or chubby or fab, you know, I think we all have experienced some sort of, some form of body shaming. I'm someone who's been chubby and skinny. I've been a few different sizes in my life. And what I noticed is it was never good enough for anybody. You know, the aunties would always go, oh, you're getting too fat. Yeah. Or, oh, you're getting too skinny. So I lose weight. And then, oh, you're getting too skinny, not eating. Are you sick? And then I gain back weight. Oh, you're getting fat again. What? Like, it's not, it's so I've learned to just be okay with my body. But some girls haven't reached that stage yet. So when they continuously hear stuff like this, and it's really disheartening. It makes you not want to make an effort with yourself. You don't really want to dress up. You don't want to wear anything that'll draw attention to you because you don't want to hear these comments.
Yeah, exactly. I think I've gone through the same, and it's so annoying because it's like, yeah, I've lost weight. And they're like that kind of, oh, they automatically think that you're sick. And you're just like, no, I'm actually looking after myself. But what annoys me the most is like, they always have something to say about your weight, and they never have something, you know, how are you? How's, you know, work, school, whatever. It's always, oh, you've put on so much weight. What's happening? You need to be exercising more, that kind of yeah. along that line. But like for those of you who maybe don't quite fully understand what body shaming is, because I don't think that's a term where you use utomaslo bishlama. I've gone to trusty Google for the definition. And so Google defines it as the action or practice of mocking or stigmatizing someone by making critical comments about the shape, size, or appearance of their body. Now, for me, like this is my own personal observation again, I often find that it's usually women who will body shame other women or just, you know, have something to say about another woman's outfit.
Yeah, I'm not sure because I have seen and witnessed more women body shame other women more than men. I mean, you know, I've had like cheeky uncles who would like, you know, after their wife has a baby, they'll have little cheeky comments about her putting on some weight. But I haven't really seen like men really body shame women. It's us. We're doing it to ourselves.
Yeah, I think the same for me. I haven't really heard men kind of body shame either women or other men. So yeah, I don't really know, like from your experience or your personal view, you know, do you think there is a difference? What a bit how it's mostly women who will body shame other women?
Well, I honestly, I don't think men care that much. You know, when a woman is chubby or skinny or whatever, I don't think they care that much. But for some reason, us women actually like, you know, and I think it's also because, you know, since childhood, you watch all these movies and you have this image in your head of what the perfect female body should look like. And even where a woman who does not have that perfect body, she tends to shame others as well. It's like you have to look perfect, like not too fat, not too skinny, have a bum, have some, you know, have a good chest on you.
Yeah.
I think we are our biggest critics.
Yeah, definitely. I think the same, like women are the ones who body shame other women. And I think with both our like experiences, we haven't really heard men body shame women, but I think there are situations where men will sexualize women.
Yeah.
And, you know, at the end of the day, it's not the same, but it's the same in the sense that it's disrespectful.
Yeah. Like I wouldn't categorize it as body shaming, but you are using my body to make me uncomfortable.
Exactly. And it makes us feel, you know, like objects. Yeah. So basically just objectifying us at the end of the day.
I know what you're saying. I know girls who, in high school, I was friends mostly with boys, right? And there were some girls, we actually didn't really know what their names was, but they would, you know, have nicknames for these girls, like, oh, the one with the bubble butt, or, you know, oh, what God, I'm saying? Yeah, you know, yeah. Like these girls weren't really like human beings to these boys. They were just like pieces of meat that was nice to look at.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
It's, yeah, that's a whole other conversation in itself, but it's like equally disrespectful and, you know, men shouldn't be doing it, period. And I think another thing when it comes to dress codes and, you know, the way someone dresses is, you know, people are always quick to say something about someone else's outfit, critiquing other people's outfits.
I guess it's where you are. It's where you are. I've noticed different places, there are dress codes for everywhere, right?
Yeah.
If you want to be accepted and not judged, you have to be in the appropriate clothing everywhere you go, which is not ideal. It kind of,
it's a lot of work.
Yeah. But I don't know how to say it, but people just need to start realizing that clothes don't matter that much. I am not walking down my community, you know, or village. It's over. They want wherever.
Exactly.
But when you go to church, like, that skirt's too short. Oh, that dress is this. Or, like, there's always something.
Yeah, exactly. I think a lot of people, you know, don't think about or don't realize that for some people, their clothing is a way to express themselves, you know, choosing a bold color, choosing a certain material or unique pattern. It's, yeah, a way for them to express themselves, their personality, how they're feeling that day. But I want to know, you know, you've touched on it a bit, but do you think, you know, your clothes are an extension of your personality? Or, you know, should we conform to the stereotypical norms?
I think it's younger girls. Like when I was a teenager, if someone came up and told me what I was wearing was not okay, I would have been like, and so? It's not like I'm going to be in any important space where I'm supposed to, you know, that is my time to be all free and stuff. But the more you grow up, dress how you want and the way that makes you feel beautiful and feel good with yourself. But also, if you know you've got a partner or a boyfriend, I guess you don't want to be parading around, like, exposing everything forever. Why would you want to show the world that, you know, that your body is your value? You show enough of it, you know, but not all of it. And it's also, you're not sure. For me, when I dress this way, when I try my best to dress in a respectful way now, it's really not because I'm afraid of disrespecting anyone else. It's I'm respecting myself. But in saying that, honestly, I really do believe women should be allowed to wear whatever they want without any judgment. It's their choice.
But another factor for us in Vanuatu, and I guess you could say it's a way we express ourselves and how we identify ourselves, is through our customary and cultural clothing. There aren't many communities and islands today that still wear customary clothing, like on the daily. I know of only one community in Santo where they still, you know, wear the numbers and wear the customary clothing proudly. And I know there are a few communities in Tana that do the same. But otherwise, the majority of the population, we know that there is a time and a place to wear certain clothing. There is a particular dress code, especially when it comes to the communities or islands. You got all certain dress codes where Yumi, especially all girl or woman, Yumi must follow them. And that particular dress code is not wearing trousers in the community and to show, you know, it's a sign of respect. But I think for other communities, they've created bylaws, or the chief has created certain rules to stop women from wearing trousers or like shorts or revealing tops. I found an article from our website, siSTAR.com.bu, from 2016. Granted, this is 7 years ago and, you know, things have gotten better. But, you know, the chief was talking about creating this bylaw. You know, he created this draft bylaw to basically try and control the antisocial behavior in the community. One of these was, you know, trying to control how young people are drinking alcohol irresponsibly in the community. And then the next major concern which came under that bylaw was to stop girls wearing short trousers and tops that are too revealing. And he went on to say, you know, the fight in that particular community, that most rape cases was due to girls wearing short trousers and showing parts of their body. Now, again, you know, this is 7 years old. It was from 2016. Things have definitely gotten better, you know, but it's still very common for women and girls to be expected to wear a lava lava or, you know, an island dress or one clothing way make emulgatali look, no, humble and respectful. And this
just relates back to, I guess, society standards and expectations for girls and women, you know, to be humble, to be quiet, to show respect at all times, and to make sure that basically they don't wear clothing that makes them stand out. And if they do wear clothing that makes them stand out or is deemed too revealing, you know, people are quick to judge and say that they're asking for it. So with all of that, what are your thoughts about these particular dress codes, law, or communities, my islands, Pliumi, Vanuatu?
This is tricky, but in just my opinion, honestly, no one really has the right to tell anyone, you know, can't wear this, you can't wear that. But it's also, it comes down to you as well as a young woman or a woman or a girl. We live in a world with bad people. There is bad people everywhere. Sadly, you're not going to be protected. So, you know, you have the freedom to dress how you like, but there should also be a limit, especially if you are living in a, you know, one of those communities where they're very conservative, you know? If you are, say you live in freshwater, you know, that's wear what you want. You're basically in town. That's fine. But if you live in a community or a village and you know very well, you know, their standards of how a woman or a girl should dress, and you go against it by wearing really revealing clothes or really, you know, there's a limit. Come on, you wear what you want, but sometimes you also have to know when it's too much, you know? There's always going to be a rapist around the corner, and it's no excuse to be raped because, oh, like you wore those short pants, or you wore this top that revealed your chest or something. It's not a good enough excuse, but the sad reality of this is these people are out there, they exist, and especially if you're a young girl and you know you walk the street at night, or you gotta kind of protect yourself. I guess that's it, because for years I myself rebelled against this. I was a big tomboy before. I wasn't one for wearing much revealing stuff earlier on in my teen years, but I was always for, you know, wear whatever you want. Always. But it was only when I grew up, like much older, that I realized I was wearing those clothes because of what people were saying. I also stopped wearing nice, pretty clothes because I didn't like the way men would look at me. I didn't like it. It made me so uncomfortable. But, you know, yay to the girls who don't care, who can just walk by these men with confidence and just feel good about themselves. There should be some kind of limit because, again, we live in Vanuatu. Vanuatu is a small Melanesian country that's still developing. There is a lot of people who are, you know, modern now and more, you know, civilized or whatever, that have more open minds. But honestly, majority of this country's population, ting blokatay, no open up kutiet lol kind something. We're still, you know, they still like this whole, you know, be humble and, you know, don't show off, basically. You have these older mamas and aunties, they see a girl wearing a nice dress and it's always like, oh, her stomach and flask play, maybe things are me nice. Or, you know, it's never, oh, she looks so pretty. It's always, you know. And as far as the pants thing, you're less, it's kind of harder for someone to, you know, rape you when you're wearing pants than skirts and dresses. But it's also, some of these girls in these villages I see wearing pants, they're wearing boy pants. You know, pants that boys wear, but they still get told off for that. How is it okay for that boy to wear it, but I can't? I mean, when I went to Daddy's Island, that's how it was. I was a tomboy. I wore pants that boys wore, but somehow it was not okay that I wore it. I didn't understand it because to me, I asked my dad, I was like, Dad, how is this? How am I being disrespectful by wearing this? And he says, he couldn't really answer me. It was really funny at that time. He couldn't really answer me, but of course, you know, our fathers are not going to admit that we're right. But, you know, I could tell he couldn't really answer me because I wasn't disrespecting anyone. I wasn't revealing my bum or, you know, showing too much leg or whatever. Mm-hmm. But because it was pants, you know, like, no, you're not allowed.
You're not allowed. And if you do, you have to masfasa one love a love.
Exactly. You're already covered all the way down to your knees with these big baggy pants, yet you're expected to put a sarong or lava lava over it. So, yeah, there's limits and lines everywhere, but I do believe that some of these rules, it goes a little too far, like that chief putting down those rules. It's sad to see them going through this, the effort of, you know, getting people together, having this big meeting and just, you know, saying like, you know, okay, we've decided this and that, but not ever having, you know, having one of the same things, but bring the boys together, sit down, boys in the community, and say, please respect them all, gel blomifala. Stop doing that. Yeah. So like I said, there's bad people out there, blah, blah, blah. But especially with our young boys in these communities and villages, only young yet, they're still young, where you can still teach them something. You can still encourage them to be good boys. And yeah, make the girls' lives a little easier.
Yeah, true. And I think with, you know, the bylaw, like you said, he could have taken the opportunity to talk with the men and the boys to be, you know, saying that, I guess, you know, putting that bylaw out there for women not to wear trousers, but then saying like, look, there is an actual problem here and it's holding them accountable, saying, why aren't you respecting the women and the girls in this community? You know, communities are families.
Yeah. No, to add to that, sorry, I wanted to say this earlier already. They do that. But in the islands, I hear about rape cases in the islands all the time. You know how these women in the islands dress. All yeah. respectful island dress.
Dresses, yeah.
Like they dress so respectfully. They follow all these dress codes given to them. Yet women and girls are still being raped in these islands. So to me, that tells me something. That tells me it's not the clothes, it's the men.
Definitely not the clothes. Yeah. And it's holding them accountable. And that's a whole different conversation that we can unpack. But I'm being cautious of time. So I'm going to go to the next question. And I just want to know, you know, what you think these women and girls feel like when these bylaws are put in place. Do you think it makes a difference? Do you think they feel any safer with these bylaws or these rules that are basically telling them how to dress in order to...
I can't speak for any of these girls. I myself am a girl who, where if I'm not happy with something, I'll speak up. Whereas a lot of, you know, these girls, especially in these communities, they don't. If they could, if they weren't so afraid to speak up, I think they would say, why should they have to when, you know, these men could just have some love and some respect for the women and girls in their community. Just, and it's not fair that in the end, by telling them that, it's almost like you're saying they're the problem and they deserve what they get because, you know, you wore this one top or this one pair of pants. I don't, it's just, I honestly think it, like for me, I know if I was in one of these communities and, you know, the chief held a big meeting and told us we couldn't, I would leave. I would not accept it because it's taking away my right.
Exactly.
I really do have the right to, you know, wear
what you
want. I want to wear. It's up to you whether you want to be respectful with it or not. But at the end of the day, it is her choice and her right. And I honestly, truly believe that it does not matter what a woman wears. Men, there are some sick people out there. You can't really stop it. Whether you whatever you wear, you know, it's going to happen. It's going
to
happen.
Yeah. Overall, it really does come down to respect. And I think we've brought that up in the conversation. You know, it doesn't matter what anyone wears, whether you like their outfit, whether their clothes are in line with your own beliefs or your own style. You know, you shouldn't judge anyone, period. You know, making a comment on anyone's body shape is disrespectful. You know, whether it's men sexualizing women or women body shaming other women, you know, just don't do it. And you shouldn't feel like you can tell someone what they should or shouldn't wear. You know, if anyone dictates what someone should wear, you know, they're breaching their fundamental duty by not respecting the rights and freedoms of others and to cooperate fully with others in the interests of independence and solidarity. And this is stated in Vanuatu's constitution. So like respect, I think overall respect is the bare minimum. Whether you know the person or not, whether you like them or not, whether you like the clothes that they're wearing or
whether
not.
Whether you have your urges, you know, that's your problem.
That is a you problem. That is your responsibility. And, you know, someone's clothes shouldn't define the way they are treated. Thank you so much, Umi, for joining me on today's episode. Such an insightful conversation.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. This has been fun.
Make sure to check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok at Sister Vanuatu and our website, sister.com.vu. This is Elsie from The Roundtable. If you want to hear more from The Roundtable podcast, make sure to tune in to the next episode.